Hi, I'm Ben, and in this video, we're looking at the ISS 360 software application in CVU V3. When you first run CVU V3, you'll be presented with this screen here. On the left-hand side, you have a list of the applications in CVU. On the right-hand side, you have a list of all the communication ports on your computer. And in the middle, you have a list of any sensors that have been detected. When CVU is first run, it'll automatically scan every COM port at every known baud rate, and it'll also scan your network to see if there's any impact subsea sensors connected. In this instance, it has detected two sensors. We have an ISA 500 altimeter and also the ISS 360 sonar. The icon for each of these gives a little more detail about the connected sensors. For example, on the ISS 360 sonar, we can see the serial number, the firmware version, and also how it's been connected. In this instance, we can see it's been connected over the network, and it's displaying the IP address of the sonar. Double-clicking on the sonar icon will take you into the sonar application, and the sonar will automatically start to scan. In this example, we have a sonar running in the impact subsea test tank, which is roughly a 2-meter diameter circular test tank, and we can see that on screen showing up there. So in the middle of the screen, we have the main sonar display. On the right-hand side, if you have a sonar with integrated pitch and roll, you get the pitch and roll readings, and you also get a little graphic of the sonar showing any motion that it's experiencing. We also have a color chart on the left-hand side here, so you can change the color palette of the sonar to suit your own preference. We typically use this kind of multicolor, going from black to blue to green to yellow to red. This bar, you can also lift up the lower red rectangle, and this will remove all the weaker returns from the display. As I move it up, you can see only the stronger returns are left on screen. As I move it down, it will start to include the weaker returns as well. Pushing it all the way to bottom means that all the returns will be shown on screen. There's also a little red rectangle at the top of this bar. If you pull that down, it will compress the bar and increase the contrast on screen. So pulling it down really far will make a very noisy sonar image and really show all the strong returns very vividly, and moving it up will decrease the contrast and just show it in its more normal state. Down at the bottom of the screen we have a gain bar, which is currently set to 35. If you increase that, it'll apply more software gain to the sonar imagery. If you decrease it, it'll remove the gain. And essentially you want to set that to a level where you see everything you want to see and you remove any excess noise from the imagery. The next item down at the bottom of the screen is your range setting. So you can decrease this to look closer in, say down to 1 meter, or you can increase this to look further out, anywhere up to 100 meters. As we're working in a 2 meter tank, we'll just set it down to 2 meters. You then have a selector which runs speed to quality, and this sets the step size of the ISS 360 sonar. If we set it to speed, the sonar will take a very large step size between pings. It will scan around very quickly. If we move this bar more towards quality, we slowly reduce the step size, so it takes finer and finer steps and gives you a finer and finer resolution. This comes with a trade-off in scanning speed. So depending on your application, you might want to set it to scan very quickly if you're moving quickly or navigating underwater. And if you get up to a target and you want to identify that target, you can move the sonar more up to a higher quality and get a higher resolution and a better understanding of what you're seeing. So that's the basic sonar interface. Now to go through some of the more advanced features, in the top left-hand corner we have a settings button. And if you click on settings, you'll be presented with this screen here. So the first settings tab which pops up is your acoustic parameters. Now by default, we leave this set to auto. This means as you adjust the range, the sonar will automatically update the acoustic parameters to give you the best range and resolution capabilities. If you don't want to use this auto feature, you can deselect this box and you can edit the start and end frequencies for doing a chirp. You could make them both the same if you want to do a continuous wave transmission from the sonar. You can select the pulse length and also the pulse amplitude. But for the majority of applications, we recommend this is left to auto, and just leave the sonar to determine the best settings for your range setting. You can also set the speed of sound here, and you can also invert the sonar image here. This is quite useful. By default, the sonar is intended to be run with the black boot end upwards and the connector downwards. If you're running it the other way up, so the boot end down, connector up, click the invert sonar image, and it'll just make sure that your lefts and rights are correct on screen. The next setting option we have is your connection. So here you can change the serial mode from 232 to 485 or 485 terminated, and you can also select the baud rate. You can also use this window to set up your network properties, so your IP address, net mask, and gateway. You can also enable DHCP if you require this. Lastly, if you have a sonar with ARS, you'll have the AHRS settings page. In here, you can tell the sonar how it's been mounted, whether it's the default value, whether it's inverted, whether it's on its side. And this will just ensure that your pitch and roll readings are all accurately referenced. You can also input any minor offsets to account for installation error of the sonar. You can also do a calibration of the magnetometer and select which axis the turns counter counts around, whether it's your heading, your pitch, or your roll. Once you've changed any settings in here, as soon as you click the green tick OK button, these will be saved to the sonar firmware. And those settings will be saved forevermore, regardless of power cycles. The only time they'll get changed is when you go back into CVU, connect to the sonar, make a change, and click OK again. If you don't want to apply the changes you've made, just click the cancel button. So going back to the other options on the left-hand side, one is your bins and sector. Bins set to auto basically means it will take a number of samples in each ping to fill every single pixel on screen. You can then set the sonar to do a full 360, or you can set it to do a sector scan. Now, setting it to do a sector scan is very useful if you're using it on an ROV and you want to look dead ahead or to the side or behind the vehicle and only update that one window. You can also set the start and stop points of that window. So you can narrow it down, you can make it wider. It's totally up to you to how you set that window. You can also enable flyback. Now, if you click on flyback, the sonar will scan from the left to the right, and then it'll very quickly fly back and scan from the left to the right. If you disable flyback, it'll scan from the left to the right, and then it'll scan from the right to the left. So it's really your preference on how you want the sonar to scan. And at any point, you can click the full 360, and it'll go back to doing a full 360 scan. At any point, you can pause the sonar and start the sonar going again. You can reverse the direction of the scan using this button. This is quite useful if you see something moving in the water and you just want to temporarily scan back and forth across that target to track it or see what's happening there. You can record a log file if you want to record everything that's happening. For playback later on, you can open it using this button. At any point, you can clear the screen just to get rid of the historic data, and it'll start updating the screen again. You also have a display button. Now, this button can be used to turn on and off different features of the display. For example, we can turn off the range from the display. You can even turn off the scan line, the grid, etc. And you can turn things back on, put heading around the sensor. You've got quite a few options there. You also have a reset view here. So if you've used the mouse or used the zoom buttons here to zoom in or move around the screen to see something in more detail, you can use this reset button here to put it back to default. So you can zoom in, zoom out. You can use this feature here to take measurements. So you just click it, and then you just click and drag on screen, and you take any measurements of the sonar imagery. So if you want to measure a target, understand its size, it's nice and quick and easy to do that. And again, clicking the measurement will turn that off again. There's also a feature to add markers on screen. So if you see something of interest, you can click on screen, add a marker to it using the left mouse button. Clicking the right mouse button will take that marker away. And you can add multiple markers on screen if you wanted to highlight something to another user, or just have them there as a reference. So that's the basic ISS 360 sonar application. If you have any questions regarding the sonar, please do not hesitate to contact us at support@impactsubsea.co.uk.